Times, and it's my privilege to introduce Vytautas Landsbergis, the first leader of liberated Lithuania. In the history of repression, the Soviet Union occupies a special place. The diabolical words, "there's no God but only the party," which cut a bloody swath across the entire 20th century, were proclaimed for the first time after the creation of the Soviet Union. Well, if there's no God and only the party, that means the regime absolutizes itself and individuals become interchangeable. And if individuals are interchangeable, nations are interchangeable also. And the Soviet Union grew to be a prison house of nations. One of those nations was the venerable nation of Lithuania. I went to Lithuania for the first time in 1977. And through pure coincidence, ended up arriving in Lithuania on the eve of the former Lithuanian National Day. And I met with a group of Lithuanian nationalists, mostly young people, who told me there was going to be a massive show of force the following day, the day of the old anniversary. They told me that through another strange coincidence, the first president of Lithuania, of pre-war Lithuania, died on the anniversary of Lithuanian independence, and they were going to go to the cemetery to lay flowers at his grave in order to mark the anniversary of both his death and the creation of the Lithuanian state. Of course, the police understood perfectly that this was a nationalist demonstration. But if they were picked up or questioned, they would say they were just going there to lay flowers. Well, the following day, just as the nationalists had predicted, there was a massive show of force on the streets. Police were everywhere, stopping people, examining their documents, and setting up roadblocks. I asked a Russian cab driver what was going on. He said there was a shooting in a robbery of the state insurance company. A mathematician who I was supposed to meet that night was picked up by the police. When he was finally released at about midnight, and I met him later, he told me what had happened. He'd been taken to a police station, the same police station where he'd been brought after being arrested 17 years previously on a different charge. And he was questioned by a drunken police officer who spoke to him in a weird combination of Russian and Lithuanian, and asked him if he had anything to do with the robbery of the state insurance company. And his reply was, he refused to answer. He said, "I'm a mathematician, not a comedian." As a result, he was finally released, and the day passed without incident. But Lithuania remained a country without a future, without a past. People didn't live in Lithuania, they haunted the place. And so it was during all the years of Soviet rule until Gorbachev announced his policy of glasnost. And the truth about Lithuanian history and the truth about Soviet repression for the first time could be spoken openly. One of the results of this new changed political situation was the creation of the movement Sąjūdis. And one of the first leaders of Sąjūdis was Vytautas Landsbergis. Sąjūdis immediately began a struggle for Lithuania's history, for Lithuania's truthful history, for a commemoration of the atrocities that had been committed against Lithuanians, for the publication of the secret protocols of the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact, and this united the country. In 1990, in semi-free, actually by Soviet standards, free elections for local government, Sąjūdis won an overwhelming victory and became the dominant party in the Lithuanian parliament. Vytautas Landsbergis became the chairman of the Lithuanian parliament and then entered a period of direct confrontation with the Soviet authorities as the Lithuanian people sought to win their independence. On March 11th, 1990, Lithuania declared its independence from the Soviet Union, and the Soviet authorities used every means at their disposal to force Lithuania to submit, including economic pressure, military pressure, and finally a massacre of innocent civilians at the television tower in Vilnius, in which people were shot and run over by tanks. But in the end, the leadership of Sąjūdis and of Mr. Landsbergis was sufficient to overcome the pressure which was exerted on this small nation by the apparatus of the totalitarian regime. And in the end, it wasn't Lithuania which was crushed, but the Soviet Union itself, because the example of Lithuania was potent in revealing one of the most important vulnerabilities of the Soviet regime, which was its attempt to homogenize individuals and to homogenize nations. Therefore, without further ado, I would like to welcome and introduce Vytautas Landsbergis, the first head of state of self-liberated Lithuania.